Gold here, and today we're going to look at how to use what's called the Waituntil instruction. Sometimes we need to wait until a certain condition occurs, and this is one of the instructions we can use to do so. I'm going to place this instruction in between these two linear moves right here, and it's fairly easy to set up, but we have to understand exactly how to do it. For this video, we're going to be waiting for a digital input to equal the state of 1. And we're going to look at how to set that up, because if you don't know exactly how to set it up, then this can get quite frustrating from time to time. So I'm going to try to keep it short. To find our wait instructions, or to find our Waituntil, if I use the common menu on the second page, I have a Waituntil instruction here. When I select the Waituntil instruction, the first thing it's going to take me to is what's called our program data screen. And it's going to show me the different data types, as we can see in this case, 8 different data types that this instruction will work with. We have Boolean, numerical or variables generally, analog inputs, analog outputs, signal DI, signal digital inputs, digital outputs, group inputs. We're going to use this first video about Waituntil with the signal DI. So I'm going to use it to wait for a particular signal. Then I hit OK, and it will take me to my argument screen. Now, we're probably pretty familiar with this argument screen from our other instructions, and it's similar to that, but notice one thing different. I have this expression highlighted, and above me it tells me it's waiting for a condition. If it were waiting for me to input just a signal, then it would say signal there. But since it says a condition, then I have to build a condition. And the way that we do that, or one way we do it, is just like this. I select the signal from my list that I want to wait until it turns 1, or wait until it goes high. So I'm going to select the signal. Now that I've got the signal in my expression up here, I need to isolate this expression, get it by itself. And the way I do that is with this expression button at the bottom. I press expression, and it looks very similar, except for one thing, I see that this is by itself. I don't see the Waituntil instruction anymore. So if you use your plus sign for your mathematical operators over here, then it's going to bring up these operators. And if you scroll down, you can see some Boolean logic there. I'm going to say equals because this is a digital input. So I can wait until it equals 1 or equals 0. I can't wait until it's, you know, greater than or equal to 1. I have to use the equal sign here. So I'm going to say equals. And I want to wait until this input equals 1, or till this input is high. Now, it seems like I could hit this new button and say, okay, I'm going to just say 1 here and hit OK. And it says 1 is not a valid data name. With an actual value, I can't use the new. The new feature, or the new here, is just for naming things. It's for creating different things, but it's for giving them a name. If I want to put in a mathematical value in here, I have to use my edit only selected. Now I type in a 1. I hit OK. Now my condition is built. Signal digital input equals 1. I hit OK again. It takes me back to the original argument screen. And now the robot knows to wait until signal digital input 1 equals 1. So when I hit OK, now we see this in my line of code. So the robot would make a joint move to wherever this position is at here. Then it will make a linear move to wherever this position is at here. Once it's at that position, it's then going to wait until input 1 is at the state of 1, or is high. If input 1 does not go high, it's going to wait indefinitely here because we've built in no other conditions. Once input 1 is high, it will then move on to the next position and continue the rest of its job at that point. So the Waituntil is a good way to build in a specific condition, and I wanted to introduce it today because there are a lot more features. If I double tap the first word await and go to my optional arguments, we see there is a lot that we can add into this instruction, and we're going to use a lot of these, but I don't want to bog down one video with way too many instructions. So thanks a lot for watching. I hope the video is informative. Make sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and more subscribers we get, the more videos we're going to put out. And we're going to cover ABB's entire pendant, every aspect of it. And we're going to try and do that in a timely fashion. And once we get done with ABB, we're going to move to KUKA, Kawasaki, and other brands such as that, for ones in which I have a simulator for. And there's going to be a lot of good information and a lot of new information coming out. So keep an eye on the channel. Thanks a lot for watching. And for now, gold out.